have you seen?
Rusty, hey man, this is Scott Bond. I got Claire with me here. Just wanted to tell you thank you. This video we're putting together is from us youth ministers. The first time I came to a revival youth minister retreat was about 5 years ago, and I knew it was a special thing. I knew you had put a special thing together. It was just a time for us to relax and get together with other guys and talk about what was going on in our lives and in our ministries. And man, you were ministering to other ministers. And man, I just wanted to say thank you from us all. Thank you from me. I know you ministered to me and made an impact on my life, and we want to say thank you. Can you say thank you, Rusty?
Thank you, Rusty.
Thank you, Rusty.
Hey, Rusty. I want to take this time to be clear that we're very appreciative to you, and we thank you for the man that you are and the Christian influence that you've been upon us and upon so many. And we're certainly indebted to you for starting this revival time to be together, and especially for you to keeping it going, as it's been an encouragement and an inspiration through the years and been helpful on a practical level, but also very encouraging and comforting on a spiritual level, emotional level, to keep us going and to remind us of what's most important. And we really, really are thankful to you for that. I think back about how long we've known each other, and I remember you being my counselor when I was in middle school, and when we went to Indian Creek during your dad's week, and thankful to have been able to get to know you then. And I remember you pulling the mattresses off the bunk beds and letting us wrestle on the beds there. And to go from there to now as a fellow worker in the church, and to see what you do for young people and how you train them and help put them into situations where they grow is really an inspiration. And we do appreciate how you've conducted yourself with the student ministry there at Graymere. And the decisions you made are an inspiration to us to see you do what's best for your young people, to do what's best with your volunteers in mind and training them and allowing them to be the heart of what you do. That takes a lot of courage to step out and do different things, and it takes a lot of courage to empower other people to do things and to let them do those. And from a distance, to see you make those decisions has been really helpful and has been very encouraging and inspirational. We do appreciate everything that you've done, and especially for the man of God that you are. Love you, brother. Thanks again.
Hey, Rusty, just wanted to say thank you for everything that you've done for me personally and for youth ministers everywhere for so long, and for so many kids. And for that, here are my kids saying thank you, holding out the Y at the end of your name.
Thank you!
Rusty.
Hi, this is a message to Rusty and his family, his friends, those who loved him. I was so sad to hear about what's happened, and just my heart goes out to all of you. We loved you. You were a great man. And I just had lunch with you recently. It's hard to believe that you're gone. Rusty, you're going to be really missed. You were a great man. And what? He didn't die. He's not dead? Oh. Apparently you're still alive, Rusty. Wow. Oh, that's good. That is good. That is good. That is good to hear. Really glad to hear you're not dead. Keep living. You're good at that. Rusty, seriously, thank you. Thank you for all you've done for me personally, for all you've done to encourage me, for all you do all the time to encourage youth ministers and anybody who loves people and loves God all over the world. I can't wait to see what the next chapter holds for you. I know wherever it is, God will be all over it. and love is going to be spread everywhere. So thank you. So much love your way.
Hey, Rusty. Greetings from sunny California. We wanted to say thank you this morning. We're so grateful for you being a listening ear for us and recommending all the best books and, you know, even starting youth conferences to help us with the work that we do. I want to personally thank you. I know Ashley wanted to thank you this morning for just being good, a good resource for us and all that we've done in the last 5 years. So best wishes to what's ahead. We continue to pray for you in every opportunity, and we're so grateful for the work that you do.
Hey, everybody. Hey, Rusty. Wish I could be there with you all. Just wanted to send this short message to Rusty and let him know how much I appreciate him. My fondest memories of being with Rusty have been there at Graymere at the Revival Youth Ministers Retreat, and then at the National Youth Workers Conference in Atlanta, when we've gone together and stayed together, four or five of us in a hotel room. Some great memories from being there, of having fun, of laughing, but then of Rusty being very generous with his time and with the wisdom and the experience that he has had as a youth minister and being so willing to share that with me. And I so appreciate him and student ministry, youth ministry is going to miss him, but I wish he and Dana all the best in the future that God has planned for them. I will be praying for you, Rusty, and pray that God blesses you. And I know that you're going to do some great and meaningful work in his kingdom wherever you go. And I love you. I appreciate you. And I will see you soon. Y'all have a great weekend together. Yeah, I meant to mention this earlier. I have Rusty to thank for the wise advice about reading 10 pages of a book every day and making that a manageable goal to complete the reading of books. Rusty very wisely offered me that advice and probably has offered it to some of you guys as well. 10 pages a day. I'll always remember that, Rusty. Thank you.
Hello. Just wanted to share my top 10 reasons why I love Rusty Pettus, and they are in no particular order. First, I love your beautiful yet very difficult to understand voice. Sometimes I really have to strain to hear what you're saying, but every time I listen, there are golden nuggets of wisdom. Also, I love the way that you will never let me live down the time in Atlanta when I almost didn't give my spare change to the homeless lady who didn't have any legs. Thanks for showing me the error of my ways. Also, I really love your man crushes on spiritual and sports figures. I also love your dedication and your great love for the Beatles and Tennessee football. It's a beautiful thing. Also, and I'm probably at the top of the list, is the way that you spoon me whenever we get to share a bed at the National Youth Workers Convention. Seriously, I am thankful for your love and support for me when I was a youth group member in your youth group. I also really appreciate your leadership and your mentoring as I was an intern at Graymere. I really, really appreciate the countless phone calls that you've answered and given advice and showing things to think about with my numerous youth ministry questions. Thank you so much for your pastoral concern and care for me during some of my rocky points in faith. And also, thank you for just your friendship. I love you, man. Thanks.
Hey, Rusty, just want you to know how much you've affected me in my life. You've helped me so much in my ministry and the things that you've provided. Brother, I appreciate all that you do, and I know that you're going to continue to do some great and wonderful things wherever it is that you're going. We just want you to know how much we love you and care for you, and we wish you well. And if you ever need any of us, you know that we're here and available for you, brother. Love you, man, and Godspeed.
Hey, Rusty, thanks for doing what you're doing, man. I appreciate your commitment, your faithfulness through all these years, and I'll never forget. Sorry, don't turn it off.
I wasn't gonna. I'll never forget you, dude. Thank you for everything. That night in my cabin. Awesome.
Seriously, Rusty, thanks for your ministry, brother. God bless you. God bless you.
Rusty Pettus. First time I met you, Freed Hartman University, Henderson, Tennessee, the year 2005-ish, 2004-ish, something like that. We were in Greek class together. And I remember looking over to this guy who was fumbling through the Lord's original language in New Testament, Koine Greek, and this guy could not read a sentence to save his life. That was my first encounter with Rusty Pettus. Rusty, I'm appreciative of you for a few things, but namely our long walks on the beach together, our whispering sweet nothings in the ear to each other, and the fact that you used to wink at me all the time in Greek class. All three of those are a lie. Seriously, I want to thank you for all that you've done for me, for being a youth minister model, and for, like on the catwalk, no, for being a youth ministry mentor and for allowing all of us to look up to you and for all the programs. I think one of your greatest gifts in ministry is the gift of empowerment. You like to use different people to help others in ministry, to help students, to help parents. And so what you do well is you empower other people. And I thank you for that. I thank you for your encouragement. And thank you for all of your work. Thank you for your honey buns. I like those. You've got awesome honey buns. And by that, I mean the food that you provided at all the Grammar retreats. Seriously, those retreats have been instrumental in my life. Thank you so much for all that you do. That would be my wife, right while I'm recording. Hold on. Hello? Hey. Do what? Yeah, that's fine. No. All right, love you. Bye. Hold on, Rusty. Main Street Church office. It'll be at 2 p.m. tomorrow. No, ma'am. Just come to the building at 2 o'clock. You're welcome. No problem. Have a great day. Bye. This was the only time I could arrange to where no one would call me and no one would contact me. Life of a youth minister. On a serious note, Rusty, I love you. I know you'll do well in whatever you do, and I look forward to watching you and what you'll do and how you'll allow others to grow closer to God and empower others continually. Thank you, Rusty. You're a blessing. God bless you, brother.
Hey, Rusty, I just wanted to send this video to tell you thank you for making a difference in my life and the lives of so many other people. It was an absolute privilege to work with you for 7.5 years at Graymere. You're an incredible co-worker, a team player with a humble heart and a love for the Lord. A person I could always talk to and know that you kept confidences and that you really genuinely cared about me. And I just want you to know how much I appreciate that. And that we were more than co-workers. I count you as one of my dearest friends. Well, Cindy and the girls and I count Dana and you both as our special, special friends. I'm grateful that my girls had you and Dana to mentor them. And among the many things that we miss from Columbia and Graymere, we desperately miss the two of you. I know this is a big transition in your life, but we pray that all goes well. We know that God has great things planned for you. And I'm just grateful that He brought our paths together. I'm grateful that my girls knew you. One of the things I always appreciated about your work with the young people was that you saw it as discipleship, helping them to become more like Jesus. You had a spiritual vision, and so everything that you did fit into that master plan of focusing on the cross. Thank you for touching our lives. Thank you for helping us to know Jesus. Thank you for being our friend. You made a difference. Make it down from a broken heart, twisted up like mine. Would you open up heaven's glory light? Shine on in, feel these dead bones light. Oh, shine on in, feel these dead bones light.